Today, I want to look at something a little bit different. This is a fantastic little gizmo to help with one of those things you're probably not even aware is taking much of your time. In this case, it's about remembering passwords. Now, what happens is everywhere you go, whether it's Facebook, whether it's Google and Gmail, bank website, you're constantly remembering passwords, which is hard to do. Even if you have one that's sort of your name or your date of birth, which are notoriously easy to crack, you generally use the same passwords everywhere because it's so hard to remember safe and secure passwords. That means that if someone ever finds out your password, they can get in everywhere and you're not as secure as you had hoped. That's where this particular free tool comes in called LastPass. The idea being it's the last password you ever have to remember. Let's have a little look at how it works. What it does is it creates what we'll think of as a spreadsheet or database of passwords that are attached to all the websites in particular that you have to get into. What's very nice about it is the passwords themselves are encrypted and they're only decrypted on your computer, which means they're not stored anywhere in a decrypted or, you know, break-inable way. So it gets to your computer, you log in, and it's decrypted on your own PC, which makes it very safe. Also, it's available in lots of different versions. So it's available on your phone, on your iPad, so that no matter where you go, you constantly have your passwords. And if you update it in one place, you've updated it everywhere because it's on a central server. So have a look at this. This is a pretty crazy password, KQO, blah, 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 blah. This is how passwords should look. They should be random and weird so that no one can hack them easily, but you can never remember these. So if you use LastPass instead, it will save these all for you. What happens is once you've downloaded this, it becomes a plugin to your browser. In this case, I've got Firefox and up here, a little icon, which is the LastPass icon. When I log into that, it goes red. And once I've logged into that, it becomes a database of all my passwords. In this case, you can see I'm on Gmail, I'm on Elance, I've got some client passwords, all kinds of different websites that you can see here that I'm part of. And it's not showing me at the moment the actual passwords because I don't want to give them away to you, right? You can even put them on a USB key, which is pretty sneaky. What it then stores, and I'm just going to hit edit here so I can show you, is it stores the name of the website, a nickname that I give it, a grouping so I can put them in groups like social or working or whatever, my username and my password, in which in this case is hidden. And I can tell it whether I want it to be auto login or not. When it is, this amazing piece of magic happens. Let's say I go to Google. In my case, I want to be able to log into Google without having to remember my password. So as soon as I hit sign in, it remembers that, takes over the browser, and boom, signs me in automatically. And does it work for everything? Well, not everything, but a lot of things. Here's another example. In this case, it's Facebook. Knows that I'm there, boom, signs me in. So the great thing about LastPass is it'll remember all of your passwords on a central database, and it will sign you in whether you're on your phone or your tablet or your computer. And it also, when you're even creating passwords, it will generate passwords for you, which it then remembers. So it's a nice, secure way of generating sweet passwords that are very complex and hard to crack, different everywhere, that keep your stuff safe, and you don't have to remember anything except the login password to LastPass itself. Make sure you don't forget that one. Write that one down somewhere. And so that's a lovely free utility I use all the time, LastPass.com. I recommend it to you.